Welcome back to Final Fantasy VII Remake, everybody. This is my inaugural recording from the Victor Sullivan Memorial Studio.
My God, I didn't know you already gave it a name. It's a good name.
You know, people were saying this was a short game, and I didn't really take it to heart until now.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, buddy.
You okay?
You okay?
Yeah. Made it through with just a couple of scraped knees back then. Back then? What do you say? We doing this? Have we? Never mind about that. Right now, you need to focus on yourself.
The three other cells, so we can restart our boy band.
They all have fun names like Promptus.
Why not?
And Ignis.
Good. Easy does it. Slow. And steady. Yeah, yeah. Hey, who are you? Who are you?
I am your everything.
Did we date in the past? You seem strangely possessive.
Oh, Cloud. There's still so much to be done.
I'm just thinking about somebody who spent a whole week modeling Cloud's tear ducts.
It's a lot of work put into that.
Maybe you're not okay.
It's okay, these 2 inches of vegetation broke my fall.
Ah, he lives. Finally awake, are we?
After crashing through the masonry ceiling.
You're...
Aerith. It's Aerith. And you are...
I don't know, 20 years ago, there were people with some very strong opinions that your name is not Aerith.
What? You don't remember? What about the flowers?
Oh, the flower girl. And this is...
An old church in the Sector 5 slums. You came crashing through the roof without so much as a lookout below. Fell right into my flower bed.
Lucky for you, I grow all my flowers on a trampoline.
Sorry, I didn't mean to...
Don't worry about it.
Really, it's an example of ludonarrative consonance, because there's no fall damage in the battle system.
Before I forget, you dropped this when you landed.
Thanks.
I've got one, too.
It's in the knot of the bow in her hair.
That's the designer's way of saying she's adorbs, with extra orbs.
No, it's special. Mine's not good for anything at all.
Bet you just don't know how to use it.
Could be. Though, I really don't mind. Just having it is enough. It was a gift from my mother. Pretty crazy, huh? Us meeting again like this. You should stay a while.
Should stay a while. Don't go to sleep. Let me see if your pupils dilate.
Oh, man. I love that he's no worse for wear from this. This is the best flower bed in the world. Hey, Cloud's all on his lonesome again, so we're just gonna switch some stuff around here. We got a titanium bangle. That was from the Airbuster.
Ah, it looks kind of like a bushing from some sort of machinery.
Yeah, I really want to imagine this isn't even really an armlet. It's just some chunk of metal that flew off of it. Yeah, we're just gonna push him just to being an all-rounder again with the Buster Sword and all that stuff. Boosting his health up with some HP ups and all that.
Tifa and Barret are looking down at their gear like, oh, he's alive!
Yes! Oh, thank God! Yeah, is there like a... Can you feel just getting just slightly lighter because you're losing some of your magic marbles, or... Because they seem to change in size a lot. They're either huge or...
And just when I had finished tending the flowers here, gotta start over. Just me, myself, and I.
leaning on a bit sick there, huh?
I'm sorry, I really have to go. I have been framed. And so of all my friends.
Hang back. We're not in any hurry.
Oh.
Hey, I think you got some solicitors. They just called themselves Jehovah's Witnesses.
One of those, I'm not sure.
Yeah. Do you know these people? Do you want me to tell them to go away?
Have you paid your gas bill?
I could stick around a bit.
Really? You will? In that case.
I'll see myself in. Thanks.
How many motorcycle stunts did you do to get here?
And who are you?
He's my bodyguard. And a soldier. Pretty cool, huh?
Huh? A soldier? Ex-soldier. Well, what do you know? You've got the eyes, at least.
You don't mind, do you? Bodyguard work's not too different from merc stuff, right?
Huh?
I guessed. From the sword. Just do this for me, okay?
Okay, but I get a 10% stake in your company. Also, I own half the building.
Fine, but it'll cost you a lot.
A lot, huh? One date ought to do it.
Huh? Well, you're weird enough to be one. What class? First. If you're gonna bullshit me, at least try to make it believable.
I'm imagining this guy took longer to come in because he was really trying to determine just how unbuttoned his shirt should be. How many? One?
Hey,
two? I just can't decide today.
You know, once you pop, you can't stop.
I'll make this quick.
You better.
Bodyguard, huh? You know I'm hers too, right?
Really? Since when? This is the first I've heard of it.
Give us a classified pop, princess.
I don't think that counts then.
I enjoy that in the world of Final Fantasy VII, just pretty much as everybody has mad ups.
Yeah, what's the gravity like in Gaia?
Just thinking of other, like, the state of this world. Like, this is a church. Seven never really talks about religion at all, though.
Mm-hmm.
Like, this just looks like a normal-ass, like, non-denominational church of some sort. Never really talk about what the beliefs of this religion is, though. No one really talks about going to church anymore, either. Maybe it's just everyone's an atheist now.
But look at the state of the floors here. Nobody goes to this church.
Good old what's-his-face. Hardly knew ya. I hate doing cleanup, but I'm damn good at it!
So a fun thing you can do with Reno here, this is a mechanic that's only in this fight. If you dodge towards him right as he's about to attack you, you'll do a little jump over him.
Ooh.
And it pressures him too if you do that.
Nice. But keep him off the flowers. Come on, be nice.
So Reno, he's really fast, generally hard to hit unless you're parrying him, but he has a ton of attacks that are not parryable. And mm-hmm.
And one difference from the remake is he got his own suit instead of wearing his dad's.
Yeah, everyone's, anybody who wore suits in the original Seven, their fit was very loose. Reno also has greater resistances to lightning, and that other symbol there is for proportional damage, so anything that would do damage based on, like, a percentage of his health doesn't really work on him.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, tons of abilities. He has lots of moves that can stun you, and then he'll follow up with harder hitting attacks after that.
What you waiting for, bodyguard?
Like the EM shot, which I have a hard time dodging because you have to dodge way earlier than you think.
Come on.
Yeah, any time he tries to get real close to you, that's your time to parry him. He's also vulnerable to poison, so hey.
There you go.
Okay. Come here, soldier.
Yeah, even though it's only doing like 9 damage per second, poison lasts for like a minute and a half or 2 minutes, so that takes up a lot of health over the fight.
Yeah. Get ready. The great thing about Reno, though, is that he is very safety-minded. He has the goggles for all these bright flashes.
Yeah.
But he doesn't use them, and that's the downfall.
Gonna make me work for it, huh? Well, lucky for you, tough guy. guy. Consummate professional! Figured this dance of ours could use a spark.
Don't get near these orbs. Even if you're blocking, you'll get stunned by them.
I hate when I get stunned by the floating Easter eggs.
Yeah, the second phase of Reno's fight is a lot harder because of all these electric mines that can stun you and lock you into really high damaging attacks. Thankfully, Reno can get pressure just from just blocking his attacks. Just making him bounce off your sword is enough to get him pressured.
Ooh. All good.
And we'll see it at the end with the extras in this episode, but Aerith has reactions to like how you're fighting and stuff. Mainly, when you beat people up, she does little fist pumps.
It's always good to have someone in your corner, you know?
Yeah, he'll eventually start throwing out even more mines, but he can't throw out his max amount like he starts off the second phase with, so...
Hell yes.
I also love when he gets staggered, his face is just kind of like, oh man. Actually good?
Weird. They're not attacking.
Hey! Open it up!
Come on.
Well, I can't say the ghosts are entirely good because there's clearly a Yorb over here and they won't let me pick it up!
Nah, ghosts suck.
Ghosts are bad, actually. Won't let me get collectibles.
I want the Lorb. Ghosts have a lovely singing voice, though. They practice this all the time.
Through the attic. Maybe we can get out that way.
Right. Through that hole.
The ghosts are good.
They're so incredibly helpful.
They saved me.
Come on.
And they didn't have to do that. There is no fall damage. We know that.
Yeah, it's true. They just...
It was just saving her the time of going up the stairs again, I guess.
Yeah.
I'll go first.
Convenience ghosts.
Come on.
She just cartwheels over.
Nothing! Up there!
Hey, no shooting!
Lady, you really gotta pay that gas bill.
Hey, you okay?
Probably.
The ghost cushioned my fall, of course.
If there's so much as a scratch on her, you're done.
Sir!
We bring her in one piece. What now? Run!
Move and I'll shoot!
Oh no, you won't.
But sir!
Could drop that.
Yeah, this part slightly different from the original.
Okay.
There was a awkward mini game in the original where Cloud was up in the rafters and there were tons of barrels up there, and he had to figure out which barrels to push over so they would fall on guys. But you know, it's like a 3/4 view pre-rendered background, so you couldn't really judge depth at all. So it was really awkward.
Now we're just doing Errol Flynn on the monkey bars.
Yeah.
Run!
Okay.
Stop her! Now.
Also kind of funny, when you're replaying this game on hard mode, you know, mm-hmm. they're shooting at you here, and it's doing like 4 points of damage if they even land a hit on you. Suddenly in hard mode, this is actually kind of stressful because all the guns are actually doing serious damage to you while you're slowly climbing.
Let's move.
Cloud, give me a hand.
If only we had some sort of lever. Do you have a strong piece of steel with you, Cloud?
I would never sully my blade by using it as a lever.
Okay, but you cut, you know, crates in half at a moment's notice.
They're in the attic. Should we pursue?
Little me.
But, sir!
Partner's got it. We are out.
I have to reapply my weird cheek makeup.
Beginner's luck.
Are we sure this isn't Johnny's brother?
More of those things.
It's like they're guiding us.
Stay close.
So cool.
I'm assuming we're living in a world where people are just naturally born with their anime hair colors. They're not dyeing it. It's just too perfect looking on everybody. Oh, speaking of that goofy barrel minigame, these were the tiny barrels you would push over in the original game.
That's not going to knock out a Shinra guard. That's nothing.
Yeah. I do miss pushing the barrels over just because they had a really funny cartoony, like, whistling noise when they would fall on dudes. It was some real Looney Tunes shit.
There.
Need to stay ahead of.
Do you sleep up here, Aerith, or?
This is just where she keeps the Christmas decorations.
Or not?
Yeah. Yes. This world has Christmas.
Okay. They, good. I mean, in the original, like, there were tons of times where people would shout, Jesus Christ, so...
Yes, they worship the Lord Jesus. I mean, not as much as they used to, clearly, just look around, but,
yeah.
People do. They do. Every once in a while, Loveless has some really heavy Christian overtones.
They gone?
Yeah, I think so.
What are they?
I think, actually, I don't know. Let's just go.
You know something about those ghosts, Aerith? Come on. Fess up. I'm real curious about the ghosts.
Okay, up for crossing the rooftops?
This is a Sonic level, you can't fool me.
There's a station.
Sonic
right
the Hedgehog
by.
Runs through here
Shall
all the time.
There are far too many surfaces what? Here that look grindable. Where's my soap shoes? In a treasure chest?
So, what's next for you?
A little bit of bodyguard work.
Right.
After that, it's back to the Sector 7 slums.
You know how to get there?
Yep.
Train.
Of course you do.
That suit from earlier. He was one of Shinra's Turks. What's a Turk want with you?
Dunno.
What about a JD?
Hey, don't Turks keep an eye out for potential soldiers and stuff?
They do more than just scout for candidates. Turks get called in to handle all kinds of situations, with extreme prejudice.
Professional bad guys. Gotta love them.
Back to my question. So what's he to you? Looked like you knew each other.
Maybe he thought I could be the greatest soldier yet.
Forget it.
Well, if you're not gonna take my brooding seriously, I'm just gonna walk on some rooftops.
Just like with every other character in the main cast, Aerith's portrayal has changed over the years. I think most people now think of Aerith as this super innocent, pure flower girl that must be protected, almost like this like holy figure or something, where she is not that at all in the original game. And just like with everyone else, mm-hmm. the remake does a very good job of preserving that original character. Because, yeah, Aerith is not... the super pure maiden. She's like a big source of humor in this game. It's really good.
You can tell that the slums are in trouble because their pipes aren't nearly big enough. Look at these shameful little pipes.
Really tiny. How are you going to channel planet blood through that?
Come on. Like, these look like real world pipes. They're so... they're useless.
What, like... I get a few, just from the massive pipes and everything, you know, the fact that this single city needs 8 gigantic reactors to power it, it really feels like Mako is an incredibly inefficient fuel source.
I actually haven't traveled by rooftop before.
Be surprised if you had.
It's honestly kind of exciting.
Well, first time and all.
Like, those huge pipes we saw on the plate in, like, episode 2 is just enough to power somebody's microwave, I think. Like, you are burning away...
Those things are energy hogs, after all.
You're burning away dozens of people's souls to microwave one pizza.
And just for the record, that's how I want to go, you know?
Fueling someone else's pizza hunger?
I'm an organ donor. You can scoop me out, and when the soul is left over, you cook a fucking pizza with that.
Wait, give me a moment. Don't just run off on your own.
Those are the words of a soldier candidate.
So petty.
Oh.
Look, I can keep doing these jumps. I bathe in planet blood. I got the glowy eyes to prove it.
Look, it's easy. You just got to find the little arrow sign and hit the action button. Yeah. Anybody can do it.
Somebody's weird getting high spot over here.
So, does no one live in these buildings?
Nope. No one to get mad if we make noise.
What sort of noise you planning to make? I can't play bass. I'm sorry. Yeah. I cannot join your band.
Can't join your band. Don't know what you play yet, Aerith, but... can't join you, I'm sorry.
I mean, you're covered with vocalists. There's so many ghosts over there.
Oh, yeah, you're set.
Looks kind of rusty.
I'll go first. It's pretty old. Be careful.
Okay.
Easy now.
You worry too much. I'm not some princess who needs to be coddled. Shit.
When I was first playing this game, this part happened. And, you know, Aerith says that line, I was just like, okay, they're laying it on a bit too thick that they're not trying to do what her character was in further stuff. But then
thank you,
they made Aerith do a swear, and then I was okay with it.
There it is. The wall.
More like sweareth.
You know, I thought about leaving once, but in the end, I couldn't.
Too dangerous?
Too much. A whole world bursting with life.
Well...
Maybe more than I can handle, I think.
If that's the problem, I got some good news, actually.
People hate the steel sky, the slums, but I don't. How could I? All that passion, all those dreams, flowing and blending together into something greater.
Well, it's mostly just wasteland outside from what I've seen.
There's, like, one bird. You'll be fine.
I mean, granted, I keep having flashbacks to when I was living in some other place that wasn't here. So there's something out there.
This time, I'll go first. After all, I can't count on you to wait.
Sure about this?
See for yourself. Maybe I'll go on ahead and leave you all by your lonesome. Just...
Maybe you shouldn't talk.
Then you talk. Tell me a story.
I don't think Cloud knows any stories.
Not for free.
Cheapskate, you're... Gotcha.
You're killing me here.
Cloud's stories are all going to be things that happened in the last 2 days. Let me tell you the story about the 3 cats that fucking hate me.
Here goes nothing.
I beat up a really big dog yesterday. Is that... Oh, I got a great story. Let me tell you about the time I beat somebody at darts. It was a great time.
Yeah, his name's Biggs. We should probably go talk to him. He probably knows where to get a tetanus shot.
You good?
Of course.
How do you get back up to your flower?
My hero.
Never a dull moment with you.
That a compliment?
Not really.
She must have rock climbing gear or something.
Thanks anyway.
Oh, she is Sonic the Hedgehog. She did the thing with the finger.
I knew it all along.
We're getting closer to the station. Even so, we'll probably run into a few monsters on the way. There's a face that screams so what?
I've fought scarier things in my sleep.
It's true, I've watched him sleep. It's not good.
I just keep dreaming of ghosts of my neighbor slash ex-boyfriend? Don't know. Not sure. Kind of feels like it sometimes. But yeah, we got Aerith in the party. Even though...
She's got a big stick.
She fights with staffs. Even though, you know, this is the first time we've got her in the party, she's got all the skill points she would have as, you know, if we had her since the start of the game.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, Aerith, you can make her, you know, put her in a couple different roles, but the big obvious one for her is that she's really good at magic.
Yeah, you might say that this is just, you know, sort of shortcut player aid, but you don't know how many mutant dogs she's been punching while you've been doing all your dungeons.
Yeah. So I've shown this upgrade before where it reduces damage. That's actually only for physical damage. There's a separate upgrade for reducing magic damage that does not come up on weapons nearly as much. You're usually going to see it come up on Aerith's weapons. But yeah, her first weapon, which I love that you just call it a guard stick. Not even a staff, just a stick. Yeah, it's good on just raising her magic stat up pretty good, as well as giving her some extra health and defense.
The stick was made for garden, and that's what it's going to do.
Yeah. She comes with some equipment that also increases her magic defense even more. I really wish you could see the accessories visually on the characters, because I want to see her running around in her little Sunday dress, but with a bulletproof vest on top of it. That'd be a good look.
Very good.
She comes with some new materia. The prayer materia lets you heal your entire party at the cost of no MP.
Well, it's just the cost of one Our Father.
She also has this refocus materia that I won't be showing off for a while. Whoever has this equipped gets a new limit break.
Ooh.
And it's a really useful limit break, but for later. We don't really need it right now. Yeah. Just gonna stack up a bunch of attack magic on her, some other things that increase her MP or her magic stat and all that. Aerith's a lot of fun to play. Also, maybe the one that's the hardest to learn how to play.
Mm-hmm.
Just because by default she's kind of fragile. Yeah, in the original game, it was very clear. Like, while everyone else in the original game is kind of just a more of a blank slate, where they're just whatever, you know, you make them out to be via materia. In the original, Aerith was super clear from the get-go. It's like, oh, she's your healer. She was the one character where it was clear that she had kind of a defined role.
Look out, Cloud!
Yeah, even though she's got a staff. Unlike the original game, where she would just run up and bop people over the head with it, she's actually a long-range character now. She spins her staff around, and she shoots non-elemental magic orbs at stuff.
Ooh!
And because that's based on her magic stat, not her physical stat, she actually does good damage with her basic attacks. She's not super weak or anything.
And she is a shoo-in for the varsity highlight team.
This one's for you! Someone looks like they're in their element.
Yeah, she gets some really fun abilities throughout the game. The little critters we're fighting here get annihilated by magic very easily, though. So it'll be a bit before we really like dig into what she can do. I also put the ice element on Cloud, so his sword is currently covered in ice chunks.
Ah, that's dope. That rules.
It looks really cool. Yeah, some of these new enemies here.
There are hedgehogs here.
Yeah.
There's a hedgehog here.
There's a hedgehog here. Or hedgehog pies?
There's some chogs in this house.
Oh, man. Love me a chog. Yeah. Look at him. I loved the hedgehog pies on the original game. Yeah, in the remake, they're really wet looking. Don't
That's
touch
a shiny chog.
It's a shiny chog. These guys, they have that avaricious bite move. If they bite you with that, they will suck health out of you and heal themselves. Aerith's unique ability is called Tempest. You have two variations of it. If you just tap the button, she shoots out multiple shots in a row. Doesn't do a ton of damage, but it can be really good for filling up the stagger meter. Also single target. If you hold down the button, Tempest will turn into a magical mine that explodes after a little bit.
Ooh.
So, Cloud, you don't know the slums that well, do you?
Compared to you? No. Training grounds, barracks, battlefields. That's the world I know.
You sound proud of that.
Well, it's not often I get to know things, so...
straight from the get-go, one of the really fun things about Aerith is she's one of the few people who just does not put up with Cloud's bullshit at all. It just, like, cuts through that shit. It's real fun.
Look, the tutorial used to be me teaching people things. That's not the case anymore, okay?
I just need to feel in control, like I know things and can teach people things.
So did the Sector 5 upper plate just collapse? Like, what happened down here?
You'll eventually hear NPCs talking about that, but you nailed it. The upper plate actually did collapse in the past, yeah.
Because everything is rubble, and it's surprisingly sunny for the slums.
Station's there.
I can see that.
Oh? Thought the world you knew didn't include stations.
Ha ha.
But yeah, there is upper plate wreckage everywhere in Sector 5. And in fact, back in Episode 3 when I pointed out, you know, just looking up at the plate for the first time, I pointed out there was one section that didn't look like it was finished. That's just Sector 5.
I can't believe this is happening.
If you would all just please calm down.
Hey,
what's going on with our shadows? What was that?
No need to shout.
Popular place.
Yeah, well, it's got a good view of the reactor. It's on fire!
In a show.
They know that. Don't worry.
Every time the camera snaps to your back, I expect to see, like, a targeting reticule on these people.
Yeah. Oh, on your way home from the church?
That's right.
Well, I'm glad you're okay. Did any debris hit the church?
Not debris, no.
That's something, at least. But you may not be so lucky next time.
Hey, you know a way to get topside other than a train?
Sorry, can't say I do.
Have you tried jumping?
Much. What a goddamn pain in the ass.
You could hitch a ride on that helicopter over there.
Yeah. You know, I pointed out back in Chapter 3, it's like, ah, shit, that texture in Cloud's apartment door never loads in. So this chapter we're in is going to be the chapter that has the most of that.
Okay.
I'm still very sure it's a bug, because I've seen people who have modded PS4s like rip the textures from this area and they look better than they do in the game. People in the comments still gonna argue with me? No. I work on video games. I can spot this shit, okay? I'm working on a new Saints Row. Don't test me. but yeah, there's definitely some weird visual bugs throughout this whole chapter that will be very noticeable in a bit.
Mm-hmm.
But a weird thing. Hey, there's some music here. Cat cheese theme? Who's that? Ask me in 3 years or so.
I don't know, but I'm pretty sure they're strong in the dark side of the force.
Yeah, it's funny, you know, a lot of the music you can buy is frequently music that doesn't appear naturally in this part of the game and will be in later remake things, but sometimes it's like, oh, here's a theme for, like, an important thing, and it's weird. It's like, are we allowed to talk about that? It hasn't happened yet. It's a pretty funky theme, though, gotta say.
Mm-hmm. For a pretty funky cat.
Gosh, the smell.
Okay, fine, I'll spoil it. One of Wedge's cats becomes a party member. Wow. What a good kitty. Also, an NPC I really like here, dude struggling with a ring. Don't know what for or why.
All right, they're taking the whole Sonic level thing a bit too far.
Oh no, my ring!
Huh?
Wait.
Oh, you just know that there's like some fan art with little animals that pop out of the capsule at the end of the level getting caught in rings like fish at the beach.
Yeah. Cool jump, sir.
Oh my god, Vin Diesel has a son.
Another Turk.
A real man on a mission.
On the hunt, more like.
For me? For you?
Don't know. Don't care.
Then, let's stick to the back streets?
How did you know about my boy band?
There will be monsters.
Better than Shinra.
Try him with our sweet and spicy sauce.
Sweet and spicy sauce! Yeah, I've always thought that Turk is like, you know, kind of looks like a relative of Vin Diesel or something, but I have found out via my girlfriend Voidburger that he also looks suspiciously a lot like Silent Hill man Tom Hewlett. So yeah, when I was playing this game and she was watching, she was like, God, I can't stop seeing Tom Hewlett.
They've got the run of it.
Please don't bite Aerith's ankles. Fully exposed. She's in danger. Oh, so her basic attacks, the third shot onwards in her basic attack is actually multi-target. So here all three rats are getting hit with magic orbs.
And that's really all they deserve.
One more shot!
I'm waiting.
Get him! Okay. Good night. No telling where they'll come from.
Monsters instinctively target weaker prey.
You'd better watch out then, Cloud.
God damn it, this girl keeps dunking on me! Can't handle this! Shinra crash a helicopter here? What is this?
You sure you want to fight?
Come on!
Yeah, the game never really told me, like, tells you that Aerith's basic attack and can hit multiple enemies at once. And once I realized that, I started using her a lot more. Again, she actually does, like, as long as the enemy isn't, like, super resistant to magic, she can honestly deal out more damage than Cloud sometimes with basic attacks.
And, you know, just everybody loves a majorette, you know?
Yeah.
It turns your party into a parade.
Yeah, and on top of just all the debris from the plate collapsing in the past, Shinra just dumps all of their old shit here, too.
Mm-hmm. From the Apollo program, apparently?
Yeah, I mean, you might notice there's a shitload of, like, stuff that looked like it's either from, you know, some type of missile program or possibly a space program.
And the largest, like, shell casings.
The biggest gun. Shinra seems like they've got the money and enough unethical scientists to just go, how big can we make a gun?
That's how the lady died at the beginning of F91. Wait a minute. I made myself sad. But I do love that your mission objective is just avoid the Turk.
Yeah.
Much like the First World War.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Over here.
I remember even as a kid playing this, and when they first introduced the Turks, I was just like, how'd they settle on naming them the Turks? Wait a minute.
Reasons kids know about the Turks. Final Fantasy VII? The Istanbul song.
Yep.
That's it.
That's it.
I wonder if we can move this.
It is funny, though, because the Final Fantasy is a series in general likes to borrow stuff from, you know, various mythologies or other fantasy things, mm-hmm. you know, that especially early on, Final Fantasy just straight up borrowed a shitload of stuff from D&D.
Right, right.
Enemies with slightly different spellings. Sometimes things are borrowed from, like, Tolkien, but with slightly different spellings so they don't get in trouble. So a lot of my exposure to that stuff came from Final Fantasy first, and then I found out it was from other things later. It's just like, oh, this still feels like a Final Fantasy thing to me, honestly.
Yeah. So if you ever go to the Republic of Turkey, you're going to be looking out for Tom Hewlett's body double.
Yep. Oh, man. Oh, no. So many chogs.
Just too many wet, nasty chogs.
I love the little dance they do when they're getting ready to cast fire spells.
Yeah, yeah. That's not Final Fantasy. That's Dragon Quest. Where you, get out of here. Get out of here.
So for Aerith's abilities, she's got two from the start. She has this thing called Arcane Ward, which feels like a late game ability because it's so good. So you can cast it on any of your party members. It just determines the position of this ability. Once you cast it, though, you put a magic circle in the ground, and any of your party members, if they are standing in the circle and they cast an attack magic spell, they will cast it twice, but at the cost of only one spell.
Ooh.
Yeah, so really, here, Jimmy? She fires off two ice spells at the cost of only one. And also, you know, only using one ATB gauge to do that.
Yeah, yeah.
It's really good to be able to do this.
Must have been a new breed.
How do you figure?
Because they went for the stronger prey.
The Arcane Ward only works for attack spells. You can't, like, double cast a healing spell or anything like that.
Ah, that's how they get you.
Yeah, and you can't target different enemies with each spell. It's going to hit the same one. unless, like, you cast a lightning spell and it kills that target, it will go to the next target. You can kind of strategize that way with that, but... Also, playing Final Fantasy games a lot, just getting exposed to words I never see ever. What is collisionous? What the fuck is that? I looked it up before and I immediately forgot what it was.
Of or relating to collisiony.
So this bracelet has bad stats, but it has three materia slots in it.
Ooh, and linked ones too.
Yeah. So, yeah, we're gonna sacrifice a lot of Aerith's defense just so that she can get magicked up.
Barrett has this equipped. Well, screw him. He ain't around right now, is he? I could use a gun today.
I wonder if there's like a sound with the materia like just voiping out of existence too, like.
Like, if it does instantly teleport, then realistically, there would be, like, a pop noise as the air rushes into that vacuum, right?
Yeah. So So yeah, I talked about how this chapter we're in has some weird graphical issues. So, you know, there's piles of garbage everywhere. Some of the piles of garbage have real fucked up textures. for instance, this really blurry mess over here. I've seen people rip these textures out. They don't look this bad when you rip them out of the game. But there's also some trash piles that look all right. And some that just look
like Cloud.
Like, And it's like, throughout this entire chapter, even aside from like the garbage piles, there'll be like stuff like this where the textures look fine, and they'll be right next to stuff that is super muddy looking. It's really weird.
There, check it out. The heart of the slums.
Is that a compliment?
Still a fair ways off.
Well, we did take a detour. Getting tired?
Nah.
Me, I'm feeling a bit hungry. How about you?
Well, you missed the sweet and sour sauce. We should have said something.
Back.
Don't have time for that.
You'll want to make time for my mom's cooking. And that's the final word on it. We'll get home quick and eat ourselves stupid.
It's going to be a short meal for some of us.
Also, just a weird recurring thing of girls wanting to feed Cloud their mom's food.
Yes.
Jesse?
Yes.
There's the real blurry trash.
Go. Yeah.
It's just weird. Again, this game still has not received any type of patches, which is surprising. I don't know, maybe it's COVID impacts, I guess, but...
And a fucking tank.
And a fucking tank. Multiple tanks. There's two tanks here. A third, and some weird robot over there. I don't know.
Whoa.
Leave this to me.
I don't think so.
So I mentioned before that the voice cast for all the characters in FF7 got recast just for the remake games. So, for a lot of the main cast, they went with, like, people who are kind of new and are not known for, like, doing voice acting. Cloud is voiced by Cody...
Experienced, but not associated with an iconic role.
Yeah, like, there are some definitely super identifiable anime voice actors who pop up for the smaller roles. Like, Johnny is Yuri Lowenthal. He voices a ton of other NPCs. Heidegger is John DiMaggio, who also voiced Waka in Final Fantasy X. but, like, Cloud is played by Cody Christian, who is probably most known as being Theo Raken in Teen Wolf.
Hell yes.
and Aerith is not, like, a new actress. She's been doing stuff since around 2010, but mostly smaller parts and, like, a miniseries or two here and there. She does Let's Plays. She did a Let's Play of this game.
Well, what are we doing here? Just watch that. Just watch it.
Yeah, it was kind of interesting that they went for kind of, you know,
robot,
unknown
robot,
people.
Robot, get in the robot, get in the robot, get in the robot.
I love these robots. I love that they have, like, one, like, hand that's meant for, like, bludgeoning or something, and then one pincer hand.
It looks like a scooper?
Maybe,
like,
a scooper,
That's hollow in there, you could scoop them?
Yeah. I also just really like the cockpit has, like, that helmet you pull down over your head.
Yes!
That's cool. I would love to see those robots in action. Oh, man. There's so much treasure in there, though.
Yeah, there's still a lorb in the church.
Yeah.
How are we gonna backtrack all the way there?
Oh, man. So the emblem on this gate here might look familiar. This emblem was on the back of all the jackets of those weird gangsters that were asking Cloud about Barrett several episodes ago. Yeah. Those dudes who kept talking about some place called Wall Market.
Wall Market, like, it sucks, but it's nice to have one at the same time.
Yeah. Oh, man. More cool robots, by the way. I love these dudes.
It is a smogger. Its job is to make smog. Who built this?
So, Yeah, if we...
Dr. Wily, what are you doing?
Right? So if we scan these guys... So Smoggers are older Shinra robots that got thrown away, and they have auto-repair procedures, so they've just been repairing themselves with fucking junk. Which is why they're all weird, weird shapes.
I respect the hustle, you know? I have a lot... Nothing but love for the Smoggers as they have built themselves. My question is, why were they built in the first place?
I don't know. Like, is the smogging ability they have due to the fact that they've repaired themselves with a bunch of weird stuff and they're malfunctioning, or were they they smog from the get-go? I just don't know.
Folks, it's come to our attention that the air is too darn breathable. And I think I found a solution.
In the original game, Smoggers were just another, like, Shinra defense robot that you would fight in reactors and stuff, but they've kind of been recontextualized to be these weird trash robots. Also, they self-destruct after they die, so get out of the way.
It's the only way to finally kill one, because if they don't self-destruct, they're just gonna crawl around and roll into their old parts again.
Yeah. If you do get hit by self-destruct, and it's like the end of the battle, it can't kill you, but it will put you down to one health.
Too dumb to die. That's the problem with Smoggers.
Don't think it'll open. What to do? That gate just doesn't want to open, does it?
Technically,
maybe there's a way to get over it?
I could cut the fence.
For you, at least.
You could get in the robot. You could steal that tank.
It wouldn't be the first time a Final Fantasy lets you get in a robot. I haven't gotten to this point yet, because Final Fantasy XIV is a very big, long game at this point. But apparently, in one of the more recent expansions, there is an entire part where you get in a giant robot and get to pilot it and shit. I'm very excited for that.
It's nice that they labeled all of the pushable ones.
Yeah.
Up, up. Up, up.
Oh, yeah, by the way, I this song is from the original game, too, and I'm... there's a worry with people that this game's soundtrack was going to be too heavily orchestrated, because 7, while it had stuff that was clearly meant to be translated straight up into, like, an orchestra, there was a good amount of songs in the game that had a lot of... that were really synth-heavy, and people were worried that, especially from the early trailers, it was all, like, really big, like, live orchestra stuff. Of like the bombing run music and stuff, but no, the songs that were that had kind of like an identity wrapped up in being like, oh, this has a really cool, weird synthy sound to it. No, they kept that stuff, thank God. Yeah, like with that little environmental, like really minor puzzle there. I wonder how much of that stuff is going to go away in the next generation because a lot of these are meant for masking loading times.
Yes, we're home free.
No need for thanks. I'd rather get paid.
You're getting paid right now.
Oh.
So, like, if Naughty Dog ever made another Uncharted, would we never have to find a ladder again or figure out how to boost somebody up because we don't have to load? We have to wait for the level to stream in? Oh, man. So many locked doors and orbs I cannot pick up.
And it's a really strong door, you can tell, because I think it's mostly weld. There's more weld than metal.
Yeah. So there are extras from the previous episode that I didn't put in because that episode was already very long. But
you don't want to ruin the big old cliffhanger.
Yeah. But we got some extra stuff from that mini game for unlocking the door.
Yes.
Shake it off. 3...
So there's more comments if you fuck up for a really long time.
Emergency lockdown disengaged. Thank God.
How the hell we made it through with dumbass here, I'll never know.
We really are in sync. Took the words right out of my mouth.
What did you say?
Okay, that's it. Let's
go. You calling me a word thief.
Make my own words.
Shake it off. 3, 2, 1. One.
Shit! Hey! I think I should lead after all. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
Much better.
We got this. 3, 2, 1. Breathe when I breathe.
How about a chant to help us time it right? Avalanche!
Ugh, this is exhausting.
It's the one chant he knows. He's very on brand.
Breathe when I breathe.
Got an idea. 7-7, heaven, heaven, hoo-ah! 7-7, heaven, heaven, hoo-ah!
Hell no.
How about this then? 7, heaven, heaven, heaven!
Which heaven do we go on? Barret, please.
2, 1.
Anyway, why does Shinra know where we hang out now?
Delta level security, disengaged. Disposal room now accessible.
Finally. I was beginning to think it'd never end.
Hey, yo, Cloud, what's the deal? You really a bona fide soldier?
We didn't train for this stuff.
All that marching with no rhythm? How did you soldier on?
Okay, that's enough of that. Let's see what's inside. Okay, final round. Don't lose focus.
There's so much
Three,
for this.
2, 1.
Delta level security, disengaged. Disposal room now.
Yeah, this
accessible.
Is for if you screwed up only a couple of times.
Mm-hmm.
Take that, Shinra! Making us jump through hoops to steal your shit.
Didn't take as long as I expected. Good work, guys.
Likewise. You made it easy.
I put my heart and soul into those countdowns.
And back to the fight with Reno. Yeah, we can,
You have to fight near the flowers?
Take a look at Aerith. She looks like, she's playing a cover shooter whenever there's bullets near her.
Aerith is my favorite youth pastor.
You're out of time!
Whatever.
Aerith, do you need a gun? I could just pick one up from one of the guys I killed already.
Brace yourself.
Yeah, here's her little fist pumps.
Hey, yeah.
Yeah. Helping your guys? So there's more comments from Aerith if you start fighting at the flowers more.
That'll do. That's a hit!
Hey, don't step on the flowers!
Let's go.
Watch your step.
Not looking good.
What's up?
You're gonna catch holy hell.
That's a line from the original game.
Oh, good.
That was hoping they would keep in. But yeah, there's some other moves Reno has here. He can manually detonate the different mines if they get close to you, and he can grab them and swing them at you. He's got a lot of moves.